As teachers approach the end of the school year, they can look forward to a well-deserved and paid break. Not so for their equally hard-working aides. That's because around two-thirds of school support staff are only contracted to work 40 weeks of the year. When those weeks are up, it's time to start job hunting because they simply don't earn income over the holidays. And while schools say they can't function without these helpers, most of them don't earn the living wage of $21.15 per hour. Most of them earn less than that. Some of them are some dollars less than that. This week they started a week of action to try and find a way out of what is increasingly a desperate situation, particularly as the cost of living rises. Our principal of Newton Century School, Riki Teteina, and teacher aide Ally Kemplen join us now. Tēnā kōrua. Nice to have you both here. Thank you so much for joining us.
Morena.
I want to talk about a situation that Whetu Kōmek has talked about this morning, saying the difference that teacher aides make in a classroom is really material and measurable and impactful. And the Prime Minister talked about this morning, and she acknowledged the issues that are being faced and said they're being dealt with. Ally, do you feel they're being dealt with? Do you feel you're being listened to?
I feel like we're all singing from the same hymn book. We're all saying the same words about how important we are and how valued we are and how we're lovely people. We just need something to change now. So we need our collective agreement sorted out, and we need our pay equity work sorted out, and we kind of need that now.
Riki, can we talk about what a good teacher aide does in the classroom, what difference they make?
John, all of our support staff are the glue that holds our schools together, and our teacher assistants are in the front line of that. So they do all those that important work with working with children with high needs, high social needs, high mental health issues, physical needs, and we absolutely need them in our classrooms.
And Whetu Kōmek, about an hour ago, was talking about the impact of that work and what a profound difference it makes in the classroom. Are we valuing it enough?
Oh, absolutely not. Look, for myself as an employer, I want to ensure that I can give job security. I can ensure that they're getting paid equitably. And at the moment, can I hand on heart say that? No, I can't.
Ally, can we talk about what, let's not use your example,
right,
but let's talk about people across the board. So teacher assistants, teacher aides, what are they earning generally?
Between minimum wage and $20.69 an hour.
So the minimum wage is $17.70.
Yep.
And we have some people, some teacher aides.
90% of teacher aides are paid below living wage.
And the living wage is what, just over $21?
It's $21.35.
Okay.
The situation, the real situation is that because teacher aides aren't paid during the holidays as well, I've had to organise food parcels for working women. I've had to organise petrol vouchers for working women. We've all had to chip in and put lunch together for working women who are working in these really highly skilled jobs.
So people are earning between $17.70 and $21 an hour, but only for 40 weeks of the year. And Riki, you made the point to me before we came on air that in fact even that is something of a misnomer, because some teacher aid teacher assistants aren't even getting the 40 weeks, right?
The funding structure is complex, and so it means that we can't pay our teacher assistants what they are worth, and they often they're not getting we're not able to give them full-time employment.
Because their funding may be attached to a particular child.
That's right, and the Ministry of Education will only give us certain hours. And so with those hours, we've got to try and employ somebody for that, and it's only very much part-time work, and we can't give them any guarantee of that employment carrying on to the next term, let alone the next year.
The situation is that isn't an easy thing to explain to people, but teacher aides in schools are paid out of the school's operations grant. They're not centrally funded like teachers are. So the school's operation grant pays for everything that a school needs to run. It pays for the toilet paper, it pays for the electricity, and it pays for the humans who work in the school as support staff.
And if there are cuts to be made, then you just think, gosh,
if your power bill goes up, you have to pay it.
Yeah.
You can't run a school without power.
Yeah.
But the only variable is the people who are working in the school as support staff.
So you think, and Riki, I'm not picking on you or Newton, which is a fantastic school, but you think, gosh, we might just have to shave Ally's hours by three hours a week or whatever.
Look, you mentioned Newton Central School is a wonderful school and we have a wonderful PTA, but often we're holding bake sales, barbecues and those sort of things just to pay for the funding for our staff.
And this is a Central Auckland school, right?
Exactly.
With a fairly wealthy parent base.
We need the government to fund this, not our communities. It means our children miss out. They miss out on basic things like a playground and all those other things that we should be fundraising for, because the money is going towards funding staffing.
So, Ally, you have literally got food parcels together and petrol vouchers. Yep. So teacher aides are just running out of money to the extent that they can't afford to eat.
Well, they're not running out of money. Whereas the living wage member says, we know if you're paid under that, you're not able to live a basic life with dignity.
And if you're only getting paid for 40 weeks of the year, then that becomes even more impossible.
Yep.
What is it you are asking for? So the Prime Minister was in before and she says, I hear you. But politicians always say Let's set aside the hearing. Yep. What would you like them to do?
We've told Minister Hipkins, told us last week, he's heard our messages. Nothing's changing. What we need is our funding to be centralised so that schools and principals don't have to make these awful, awful decisions about whānau, about people in their school.
Right, so taken out of the operations budget of the particular school and funded so that the ministry assigns a sum of money so that you know what you're dealing with.
Yep.
Okay, so that's the first thing you're calling for?
To have living wage as our minimum wage for the first people who are starting out and to increase from there. Our pay equity campaign is, our pay equity work is really robust and really strong, and it looks at the difference between this women's work, this nurturing work, we love doing it for a little bit of pocket money work, and then the very highly skilled professional work with extremely high needs children.
Do you have the sense that there's that degree of condescension? Oh, you must love children. And
there absolutely is.
Right.
And that's
you don't need to eat, you don't need to pay the rent.
No, because your husband will look after you. So that's not the case anymore with the needs of the children that are coming through schools, more and more challenging needs. We're the ones who support them.
Riki, can I take Ally's point and give you the final word here? What sort of needs are we talking about? The work that teacher aides, teacher assistants are doing, what are we talking about?
Look, we need these people to be professionals, and we want to fund the professional development. We want them, they're absolutely critical for our schools. So we want to ensure that we give them job security. We want the government to act on things now. The negotiations have been going on for 3 years. Stop dragging your heels, get it done. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we could go into Christmas with a present to our 18,000 teacher assistants of job security and funding so they can actually have a Christmas?
Is centralised funding, is that what you're calling to?
Absolutely, okay, centralised funding.
Okay.
Don't put the onus back on schools and using the minimum money we already have to fund this as well.
Riki Teteina and Ally Kemplen, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
we really appreciate it. From Newton Central School, but speaking on behalf, I'm sure, of 18,000 people in similar positions, we're very, very grateful for your time. We're going to put those issues to Chris Hipkins and get a response from him, we hope.